The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 8th chapter, text number 14 through 15, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in October of 1966 in New York.
Ananna Chita Satatam Jumang Smarati Nittasaha Tasyaham Sulama Path Nitta Yuktasya Yogina. Last day we have been discussing how the impersonalists they transfer themselves in the spiritual kingdom. The yogis and the jnanis, they are generally impersonalists. So, for them, the process at the time of death, they vibrate the transcendental sound Om, Omkara. And by that way, they transfer to the spiritual world, but they do not enter into the spiritual planet. This point we have discussed. And the risk is that if we do not have any rest in the spiritual planet, if we remain in the outer space only, then there is risk of coming down again in this material world. The Bhagavad confirms it, Jannir Vindakha Vimukta Manila Tayasta Bhavat Abhishuddha Buddhaya Harijya Kritchena Parang Padang Tataha Patanti Adha Anadita Jismadanghaya. It is said that persons who are interested of becoming liberated, Jinnir Bindakho Vimukta Manina, simply by the concept of impersonal merging into the spiritual existence. So, Jinnir Bindakho, they consider themselves that they are liberated. That is also a point of liberation. But the Bhagavad says, although they consider themselves as liberated, the avishuddha buddhaya, avishuddha means their knowledge is not very pure, not yet pure. Avishuddha buddhaya. The result is, the arujya kritchena parang padang tataha, they can rise up to the supreme, absolute platform by their penances and austerities, meditation, that is right. They can reach to that platform. Arujya kritchena. Arujya kritchena means raising themselves, elevating themselves by severe penances to that platform. Arujya kritchena parampadam, the supreme, absolute platform. But patanti adho, they again fall down in this material world. Why anadrita? Because they have not taken seriously about your personal future. Anadita jismat anghaya, without worshipping your lotus feet, the result is that they come down again in this material world. Just like however you may rise in this material space, 5,000 feet or any, if you have no rest in any planet, then naturally you will come down again. Naturally, because you have no rest. So in the spiritual effulgence, if we do not have any rest, then we are sure to come back again down. The reason is that I have already explained that our life, we as living entities, we are part and parcel of the Supreme, Sat-Chit Ananda. We want pleasure. So, impersonal feature does not give us that pleasure which we want, which is our demand. That pleasure is available in the spiritual planets. If you enter in any of the spiritual planets, then that spiritual happiness and exchange of pleasure you can attain. Therefore, the Lord says, Krishna, ananna cheta satatang jumang smarati nittasa. A person without any deviation, ananna cheta, without any consideration of jnana, yoga, or any other process, simply devotional process, simply surrender process. My Lord, I am your eternal servant, please give me your service. Let me engage, let me be engaged in your service. This is called ananna cheta. Ananna cheta satatam. Satatam means always, 24 hours, 10%, without any disease. This is Krishna consciousness. If anyone is engaged in such Krishna consciousness, 24 hours, 10%, then jumang smarati nittasa, always remembering. Suppose if you are engaged in some work, naturally you will be thinking of that particular work. When you go to your office and work, so you have to think always of the office business. That is quite natural. Similarly, if you engage yourself in the business of Krishna consciousness, naturally you will be always thinking of Krishna. Therefore it is said, jomang smarati nittasa, always remembering. Tasyam sulava partha, my dear partha, for him I am very cheap. Sulava is very easily available. God, Krishna is called Ajita. Ajita means nobody can conquer God. Therefore his name is Ajita. Just like God has innumerable, he is unlimited, and his functions and activities are unlimited, and according to his activities, his names are also unlimited. So this is one of the names, Ajita. Ajita means the personality who is never conquered. Nobody can conquer him. Therefore his name is Ajita. So there is a very nice verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Gyane prayasam udapasa namanta eva jivanti sanamakritang bhavadiya vartam sanishthita sthitigatang tanuvang manovhi prayena ajitopi jitopasi tai stilapyam. Brahma is praying, Lord Krishna, in this way, that a person, gyane prayasam udapasa, in the giving of the futile endeavor to understand the Supreme by one's limited knowledge. Give up this attempt. Jnani Priyasa. Jnani Priyasa means that the theosophist, the philosopher, they are trying years after years, life after years, what is God? What is God? What is the absolute truth? Just like we throw Sputnik, how much this space is length and breadth. This is frog philosophy. Just like several times I have decided, a frog is measuring the length and breadth of Atlantic Ocean, you see. A frog whose life is within the well, 3 feet, 3 cubic feet measurement, he is trying to measure what is the length and breadth of Atlantic and Pacific Ocean. Similarly, our attempt to measure how far this outer space is, just as a futile, and what to speak of this space, our measurement of our limited knowledge, with the limited knowledge, if we want to know how far, how much long and short is God, it is a futile attempt. Futile. It is not possible. So Bhagavat recommends jnane priyasam udapasa, just give her this nonsense habit to measure the Supreme. It is not possible. The jnane priyasam udapasa, a person who has taken this determination, that it is futile, it is useless, to try to understand what is God by my limited knowledge. He's an intelligent man who takes this decision. So jnana prayasam udapasa namantaiva. Just become submissive. Just try to understand your position. That is a very insignificant segment in this material world or in the creation. Namantaiva. Just become submissive. Jnana prayasam, giving up this endeavor to understand the Supreme by one's limited knowledge and just become submissive. Then what is the process? Salamukhiritana Thabadiya Vartam. You just try to understand the Supreme from the reliable source. Salamukhiritana. Sat Mukhiritana. Mukhiritana is from the lips. From the lips of realized source. Just like Arjuna is understanding about God from direct Krishna. From the lips of Krishna. Sarva Padmarava Mukhan Nishrita. So this is the process. So similarly, if we understand about God through the lips of Arjuna or his bona fide representative, that is the process. Jnani prayasam udapasa namantaiva, submissively, one who tries to understand the transcendental nature of God from the reliable source. Sthane sthita. Never mind what he is. Never mind what he is, either Indian or European or American or Japanese or Hindu or Muslim. Never mind. So, sthane sthita, just be situated in your place, that doesn't matter. Suti Gautam, just try to understand through your ears, by oral reception. Oral reception. Sanmukhritam Suti Gautam. Suti means this ear. Reception through the ear. Sanmukhritam Suti Gautam Tanumang Manovi. Then just try to practice it in your practical life. Tanumang Manovi. Je prayasa ajita. My dear Lord, you are unconquerable. By this person you become conquered. Simply by hearing. It is such a nice verse. God is not conquerable, but he becomes conquerable. He is conquered by devotee who gives us this nonsense process of understanding him by his limited knowledge and becomes submissive and just try to hear from the right source and try to apply in your life, then you become a conqueror of the Supreme. Similarly, Lord Krishna also said that Tasyaham Sulabha. Sulabha means I am easily available. God is not easily available. It is very difficult. But for a person who is constantly in Krishna consciousness, the Lord says himself, for him I am easily available. Easily. So why don't you take up this process? There is another nice verse in the Brahma Sanghita. The purport is that a person, if he tries to understand by his sensual process, this is called sensual aroha pantha. Aroha pantha means trying to ascend. There are two kinds of ways to understand knowledge. One process is aroha pantha, ascending process, and another process is descending process. What is that aroha pantha? Aroha pantha means that I shall understand what is God by my own knowledge. I don't care for any authority, any book. I will understand. I will meditate, I will think, I will philosophize, and I will understand what is God. This is called aroha pantha. And against this, there is avaroha pantha. Avaroha pantha is getting knowledge from the authority. There are two processes. Now, out of these two processes, the aroha pantha, one who is trying to understand the Supreme by his own limited knowledge, for him it is said in the Brahma Sanghita, Pandhasu koti satavasya sampradamya vayo rathapi manaso manipungavanam sapastya pravadasina abhisintatate govindamadipurisham tamaham bhajam. Now, Panthasu Koti Satavasta Sampram, by the ascending process, if anyone makes progress with the speed of mind and speed of air, you know the speed of mind, how it is powerful. You are sitting here and you can think of thousands and thousands of minds are immediate. Just see the speed of mind. Similarly, the velocity of air is very thousands of miles in a second, a velocity where was. The example is given here that if anyone traverse on the path of ascending process with the velocity of mind and air, Panthasu Koti Sato, and if he makes progress, not only for one day, 2 days, 3 days, 1 month, koti satavasra, millions and millions of years, if he goes in that speed, panthasu koti satavasra sampradamma, bayo rathapi manaso, bayo means air, by the airplane or sputnik, or by the speed of the mind, if he makes progress, panthasu koti satavasra sampradamma, Vayu Rathapi Manaso Munipungavana, and not very ordinary man, but Munipunga. Munipunga means the highest thoughtful. Punga means the greatest. And Muni means thoughtful, thinker. If it goes on for millions of years in the speed of mind and the speed of air, still he will find still not knowable. Not knowable. Panthasu koti satavasya sampradamma vayu rathapi manaso munipungavanam sapastila prabhadasina abhichintatasya. Still, the subject matter remains inconceivable. Inconceivable. Not definite. But here is the definite information. Just in the Bhagavad Gita you understand that Ananya-cheta, without any deviation from this path of Krishna consciousness, without any deviation from the devotional service in submission, if anyone thinks always of Krishna, Krishna says, Tasyaham sulabha. Sulabha means I am very easily available for you. Tasyaham sulabha prattha. Why you are so big, why you become so cheap to this person? Because nitya jutsasya yogina. Oh, he is constantly 24 hours he is engaged in my service. Oh, I cannot forget him. This is the process. Just become submissive and attract the attention of God. Then he will be successful. Just try to. My Guru Maharaj used to say that don't try to see God. You work in such a way that God will see you. God will take care of. Don't try to see God. This is the process. I want to see God. Oh God, please come and stand before me. Oh, just like He is my servant. God is no one servant. You have to oblige Him by your love, by your service. That is the process. Here is Tatsaham Sulabha Pratha. Anyone who is engaged in that way, in that submissive way, always constantly, without any deviation, in Krishna consciousness, for him, God is very cheap, although he is not, he is unconquerable. Take this process, Krishna consciousness. Very easy. This process is given to the humanity by Lord Chaitanya. And Rupa Goswami, the first disciple of Lord Chaitanya, he appreciated it. He was a minister in the service of the Vedic Mahavedan kingdom. And he became a disciple of Lord Chaitanya. And when he first met him, he offered himself with this verse, nice verse, Namo Mahavadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namini Gauratpisi Namaha. My dear Lord Chaitanya, you are the most munificent personality, most charitable, the highest charitable person. Why? You are delivering Krishna very cheaply. You are delivering Krishna very cheaply. Therefore, nobody is comparable with your charity. We want Krishna. The whole, we are hankering after Krishna, the most attractive, the most beautiful, the most opulent, the most powerful, the most learned, and the most beautiful. That is our hankering. We are hankering after the beauty, the powerful, the learned. So why? The Krishna is the desire of everything. You just turn your attention to Krishna. You'll get everything. Everything whatever you want, whatever your heart's desire, it will be fulfilled by this Krishna consciousness. So, this Krishna consciousness was given by Lord Chaitanya. Therefore, he is called the Namo Mahapadana. So, you are the most powerful charitable personality. Nobody has given such a thing, Krishna, because we are all in want of Krishna. So that is the process given by Krishna himself. And here Krishna says that I am the Sahang Sulava Partha. I become very cheap to him. Whom? One who is constantly engaged in Krishna consciousness. And if you remain 24 hours in Krishna consciousness, then just like the impersonalists, the yogis, the jnanis, they transfer themselves to the spiritual world and merge into the impersonal and effulgence, you enter into the planet where Krishna is. Then, what is the benefit? You can ask, well, suppose I do this and enter into the Krishna planet, then what is the benefit? The benefit is stated in the next verse. Mam upetta punarjanma dukkhalayam asasatam naapnubanti mahatmana sangsiddhim paramangataha. My dear Raja, if anyone comes to me, mam upetta, by this process, by Krishna consciousness, then the result is punarjanma dukkhalayam asasatam na apnivanti. He does not get any more to come back into this material world full of misery. This material world is certified by the Supreme Lord, the Creator, as dukkhalayam. Dukkhalayam means the place of misery. How you can make it comfortable? Can you make it comfortable by your so-called advancement of science? No, it is not possible. But you do not know what is dukkha or what is suffering. Real dukkha is, real suffering is birth and death, old age and disease. But we have set aside, because we cannot make solution of these things, we don't care for it. We are after Sputnik and atomic bomb. That is our scientific advance. Why don't you solve these important things which is giving me all a suffering? They have no power. So here is the solution. The Krishna says, Maam Upetta Punarjan. If anyone attains into my platform, then he does not come back again, Punarjanma, rebirth again, where Dukkhalayam Asasatam, this place full of misery. Full of, just try to understand that this place is full of misery. There, in the modes of ignorance, we cannot understand. Just like the cats and dogs and hogs cannot understand that what miserable condition of life they are pulling on. Similarly, human being is called rational animal. They are animals. But at the same time, they have got the rationality. But that rationality is being used in the purpose of animal propensities. That rationality is not being used how to get liberated from this miserable condition. That is misuse of rationality. Now here is the solution. Krishna says that if anyone remains in Krishna consciousness 24 hours, without any deviation, the result is that he comes to me. And if he once comes to me, maam upetta punat janma dukkhalaya masa satam nabnuvanti, he does not get again rebirth of this miserable life. Why? Now mahatmana sansiddhim paramangataha. They are great souls and they have achieved the highest goal of life. So this is the highest goal of life. We should know our self-interest to achieve this highest goal of life, not temporary dolls. You see, children are captivated by temporary dolls, but not a sane man.